Yo, what is up, everybody? How we doing? Happy Saturday. Can you hear me? If you want to let me know in the chat, make sure we're all good. We're going to get this show started in just a second. Awesome. You guys hear me? Fantastic. Well, guys, happy Saturday. We are back for another show. So yes, you guys just got muted. We're going to start unmuting you again. Just some people were very loud. Just be mindful if you are unmuted. Just keep it down. Don't talk. But guys, you're not here for me, even though you guys paid for my college fund last week, which I appreciate. You guys are here for the person that you've seen on stage with the Impractical Jokers to a sold-out crowd at Madison Square Garden. He is back tonight performing for a sold-out 182 of you. That's unbelievable. We got cooking. We got comedy. We got a lot of fun in store tonight, and hopefully we will get started on my 401k. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, as soon as this video starts, let's get Jiggy with it, ladies and gentlemen. Jiggy!
All right. Welcome, everybody. Let's get the light on. Oh, I got my stage light. Oh, my God. Welcome to another edition of Tastes Funny, where we cook, we tell stories, we hang. This is a big night, Saturday night. It's the first day of summer. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. Happy Father's Day to all the – maybe you're – maybe there's some people who will become a father because of this show tonight. You never know. But happy Father's Day to all. And if you're a kid, scientifically, you probably have a father. So don't forget about them tomorrow. Say hello. Write a card. Send a card. That's something you should do. Shout out to everyone who's in the UK, because it's actually Father's Day in the UK right now, because it's what time is it there? It's almost 1 a.m. So I know we have a lot of people watching from over the sea. So thank you guys for tuning in to the show. What do we have in store for us today? What are we doing? That's a great question. Thanks for asking. So we have the format today is I'm going to be attempting to cook something. You guys are going to have the opportunity to sabotage me, and we're going to have some fun. I have a wheel of misery, a wheel of misfortune. There's going to be some funny things on there. There's going to be some painful things for me to eat or drink. But the whole idea is just to have fun. I created the list. I did it, so I know what I'm in for. And then if we raise tonight over $2,000 today by tipping, you can send tips to Venmo or PayPal at Jiggy Comedy. If we raise over Ethan, great job. Great timing on that. If we raise over Jiggy. And we raised over 2,000. You can come back to me, Ethan. This is something that I've never thought that I would purchase this. I Amazon this. Amazon, I'm going to ready Ow. Strip How Max down. My thigh. It's Ow. Almost 4th of July, gang. So you know what that means. Smooth thighs make for smooth dives.
Because you could tell them like what you're waxing at 4,000? Wait.
$2,000, yeah. I'll do both legs for $4,000. But I have this ready to roll. I've never done anything like that, so wish me luck. I have a whole chop cam is going to be monitored by me this time, so let's back this thing up. I don't know if you guys can see all the different things that we have here. This is my whole area here. We have the world's hottest peanuts making another arrival. We got pickle shots. I have a wig. Fake nails down there. I don't know if you guys can see that. This is an interesting one. This is fake hair to go in my little cul-de-sacs. I have face tattoos. I'm 3 years old, or at least Amazon thinks I am. We have tiny hands making another comeback. I have sour warheads. We're going to be trying to make pastas. That's my little pasta area. And of course, shots and drinks. Okay. So with that said, we have two different wheels. We have a wheel where I tell stories, so random stories, things from my past. That's the misfortune wheel. I guess we can stay there. We'll go through this one first. So I read off some of these, but I'll tell you what we got going on. Scroll down there, Ethan, so I can read it. Okay, so we have face tattoo, chopsticks only, mean cooking with a chopsticks only, butter knife only, random ingredient. So you get to choose the ingredient I have to put inside the dish. I'm nervous about that. Wrap it out is you give me three words and I'll do a rap about it. If you were at the last show, hashtag butthole time machine. I mean, we're making hits. Spice it up is you get, I will put cayenne pepper in my dish, hopefully not screwing it up. I have two more R&H delicious beers, drink responsibly, but I will shotgun. I have two of those. Fake hair powder, which is my kabuki, which will be fun. Oh God. Shot of, so I can do a shot. I have rum, I have moonshine, I have a bunch of different shots. Mike is actually Magic Mike. I think Beatrice is here. She'll know what that is.
Mm-hmm.
My MJ song. My MJ song is a song that I wrote. Hold on right there, Ethan. I made a song when I was, I think, like 19. Maybe 19, using a Michael Jackson like beat that I made. And no one's ever heard it because I buried it in YouTube. But if you pick that one, we'll play it. Oh, saltine challenge I can't do because I forgot to get saltines. What an idiot. Yeah, we have a great cry. It's not the same. All right, it's off.
Cancel cookie, the fucking show. We're done.
I know. Cookie race, I saw this one online. So you have to, like, I put a cookie in my forehead and I try to eat it in my mouth in a minute only using, I don't know. You get it. Serenade You, if you pick that one, I will try to make up a song, like a boy band song, about you on the spot. Fake nails, brain freezes. I'm going to try to eat one of those Icy Pops as fast as I can in under 30 seconds. Become an old lady, hence the wig. That's a fun one. I mean, how could you not want that? Sour face is biting into a lemon. We have multiple dance breaks on the wheels today. Tiny hands, hottest peanuts, pickle juice shot, and a scavenger hunt where you get to pick three things from my house that I try to get, or I have to take a shot. So that's what we have on the wheel of misfortune.
Uh-oh.
Who was that? Ethan, what'd you just take off? Shake my ass? What did you put?
Put it back.
Shave my ears. Eyebrows off. No, not doing it. What do you think? James Murray's already done that. Okay, ass. And now so if you tip $100, you get to pick something from that wheel, and then periodically the show, I will do a spin of that wheel. I'm also going to be doing telling stories, so go to the story wheel. So these aren't like jokes, they're not like stuff that I usually do on stage with a few exceptions. Scroll down there, Ethan. These are some of the ones. I tried to make them ambiguous besides the first one. Chocolate raspberry ball sauce, one of my favorite stories. Uber errands, umpiring disaster. I hope that lands on that at some point tonight. Public boner, first kiss, first time drunk, dream girl prom date, summer camp job, the Titanic booby. I hope someone picks that one. Pulled over in Nebraska. What is that one? Eating around animals. I hate the dentist. Wish I had pants. Jerk joint. Bad at texting. Bumble message. Halloween crime. Scroll down. Housekeeping in hotels. High school girlfriend Melvin from Oklahoma. Girlfriend triggers. Love me forever. Starship Explorer. Haunted roommate. Trouble in the suburbs, and chemically straightened hair. So those are the different stories that we have that are potential. So come back to me, Ethan. I'm exhausted. That was a lot to discuss. A couple different things I wanted to mention. I also have merch for this show. What? Jiggy has time to make merch? I do. So I made a you can get my merch online. I have Tastes Funny merch. Where is it? Ethan's got this. Yeah, so there you go. So we're going to put a link inside the chat, but if you want to pick up, scroll down to the Tastes Funny stuff. There's some cool, yeah, there you go, right there, up a little bit. I have laugh shirts. These are the Tastes Funny ones there in the middle. Oh, there you go. You even zoomed it up. So you can scoop one of those up if you are interested. Okay, one last thing before we get started. I've never done this before. I've never even offered this before, but I'm like, I'll throw it out there if you want to do it because it takes so much time. And some of you saw that I released a comedy album of my comedy music that I put out for the last few years. I just got that released yesterday on iTunes. So I figured I'd put this as an option. If someone contributes $500 or more tonight, I will make an original song and music video for you. I've never offered that because of how much time it takes. But if you want that, I'll make the song about you, about your husband, about your wife, maybe your divorced and you want it about your ex-husband or your ex-wife, but we can make it about anything, and I will do the music video. I'm only doing two of those because it literally will take maybe weeks to do, but it's out there as an offering tonight. Okay, that's it. Drum roll. What are we making tonight, Jiggy? I'm making shrimp scampi. Now, what's different about this shrimp scampi tonight? I'm nervous to even say it. Why did I do this to myself? I'm home making the pasta, bruh. I'm home making the pasta. Now, I've only done this once, unsuccessfully. It didn't work. But I do have a pasta thing. And so we're going to try to make the homemade pasta, and I'm going to make a cocktail and a little shrimp scampi situation. Okay, so Ethan, with that said, let's spin that story wheel, and then I'm going to start making the dang pasta. Spin the story wheel. What story will I tell? What will it be? What could it be? High school girlfriend. Oh, this is a quick one. Okay. First, a couple of didn't last very long. A couple of shout outs before we get started. Shout out to Mary McCann, Valerie Curtis, Bill Berry, Kelly Glitzenbach. I can mispronounce that every time. Carly Roberts and Julia Patton, shout out to you. Also, I am going to do a shot right now because I got to loosen up and got to have a couple of shots. So, this one to Bridget Barone and to Maria Williams. This one goes out to you. I'm drinking, this is a rum shot that I, a little rum lemonade and a little iced tea action. That's what I'm gonna be drinking tonight. Wish me luck, these are strong. All right, thank you guys. Thank you for coming out. I think this is gonna be a really fun night. You're in for a treat, I hopefully, or not. Either way, it'll be fun, hopefully. There you go, cheers guys, thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Bye. Cheers. Cheers.
That's the first one.
First dude. One's down, gang. All right. So first, let's go down to Chop Cam. All right. So 1 cup of flour, they say, and you got to put a little well in here, right? Oh, this is gonna be a disaster. This is gonna be a mess. You got to put a little well down here, right? Keep a little flour there down there at the bottom. Okay, so my high school girlfriend, she broke up with me. My first girlfriend was named Sarah Gross. A lot of people have heard that. But my high school girlfriend broke up with me in front of all my baseball team when I was in 10th grade. And the funny thing about that is her name was Isis.
Oh.
I know. And so like years later, when everything started happening in the Middle East, I was like,
There's your sign.
It's destiny.
Okay.
Jiggy, would be just as explosive though?
What?
British.
You can't be funnier than me, Ethan.
Sorry, Jiggy. I learned from the best.
All right, now we got to crack this egg. I don't know. How do you crack an egg? I don't know.
Against the corner.
Okay, I don't know. I just slam it.
All right. All right, guys. You guys chill out, little sprout. All right. Now we got to add a little bit of olive oil, I think, now in it. A little olive oil in it. We got to do a little salt. And a little bit of pepper. You can spin that story wheel, Ethan. Let's see what else we got on there. That was a quick one. Jerk joint.
There's so many implications.
We're going family friendly right at the beginning. Okay. So this is gonna be hard to tell stories as I cook now. All right, so this is, I'm breaking the yolk up and then just trying to slowly mix in the flour. The reason why I'm doing this first, gang, is I'm gonna make this dough and I'm gonna try to refrigerate it so that I actually have a chance of this being digestible. So the jerk joint story is, I was going to brunch here in New York, and I asked my buddy, I'm like, where's this place? I've never been to this restaurant before. Where are the directions? So he gave me the cross streets, and he told me that it's right next to the jerk joint. What's a jerk joint? I thought maybe it was like a Caribbean chicken restaurant or, who knows? And he said, he's like, you'll see. So I get there, I go to brunch. The only establishment that's right next to this restaurant is a psychic. So I go to brunch with him. I'm like, why'd you call the psychic a jerk joint? And he goes, I thought everyone called it a jerk joint. you know, you go in there, they read your palm, and then they bring you in the back room and jerk you off. I don't think you've ever been to a psychic. I don't think that's how it works. I don't think anyone puts their hand out and goes, looks like your lifeline is, you know what? I might just take you in the back and jerk you off. Yes, that's actually why we're talking about that. Okay. How are we doing here? I don't know if this is... Oh, I was supposed to add another egg at some point. Crap. I hope I don't get a crumb in there. What do they call the shell?
Crunchy.
That's flavor.
I think I was supposed to do this earlier. Now I feel like my well is all... It's very wet. Come on, flour. Has anyone made fresh pasta out there?
Yes.
Done.
Nope.
No?
Yep.
Okay. Well, that makes all of us. I saw this. When you see it in the YouTube video, you're like, I can fucking do that. And then you're here in the midst of it. Now I think I have to use my paws. Make sure your paws are all clean. Now you gotta start working it in. Oh, God. I don't
think I'm working. How does that feel?
Like it looks. Not good.
Like it looks.
Yeah, so I actually made pasta one time. And I went to Italy, humble brag, and I went and I learned how to make pasta. But, like, I was mostly just watching her do it. You know, I didn't really touch much. It's easy to be like, oh yes, that's the technique. But then when you're all up in it, it's really it's much harder. Okay, this looks like it's coming together a little better. What do you guys think, gang?
It looks great.
It's getting there.
Not quite.
More flour.
Yeah, more flour.
Mm-hmm. More flour?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, all the flour should be gone by the time.
Who said that? Who is that?
It's Rob.
Oh, okay. What's up, Rob?
Not much.
Margarita Rob, everybody.
Woo!
Margarita Rob. No, that's too much. I think that's too much flour. I got some on, they call this board flour, I think, right? Margarita Rob, have you ever made fresh homemade pasta before?
I made gnocchi with my mom a long time ago, but it's been probably about 30 years since I've done it.
So
but it's
I'm
looking good so far.
You
know, I mean, I got the technique.
How do you know more than me and you haven't done this in 30 years? This doesn't look like anything the last time I did it. He did it like in the oil shortage of the 70s.
All right, man, I'm not that old. Shut
back
up,
when bro. Roosevelt was president, I made pasta because we needed it.
You keep making a pasta. It looks so good.
It looks so good.
Back in the old country. Do we need a little bit more flour, you think?
No, I think that's good.
I mean,
how sticky is it right now?
I could make an emergency call to my Italian in-laws if you want me to.
Yeah, I don't want you to.
Long as not, it's not sticking to your hand anymore.
Yeah, if it's not sticking to your hand, it should be okay.
That's what she said.
Exactly.
Everyone's got friggin' jokes, except for me.
Because you're working on the pasta.
I'm working on the thing. All right. This feels pretty good, but I'm going to hit it with a little bit more flour. And shout out to the – do we have the Ivies on the call? They sent me this big bag of flour. Could you scoot the camera over this way? Do a little scoot? Just a little scoot. You see this big bag of flour? I got sent that in the mail. Who sends flour in the mail? I think people probably were worried for me and the person who sent it. But big she was sending the flour in the mail. Okay.
Nikki Franco this says it looks good.
Huh?
I said Franco says it looks good.
All right. I'll take that as this is called kneading, which sounds easier than it is, but it's a little bit too sticking to me. So hopefully when this comes all up in the fridge, you know, it becomes one little unit. Okay. And then we can make a cocktail. I'm going to have to wash my hands, though. And I have a fun cocktail for you. It's made with moonshine tonight. What? Jiggy's crazy. Jiggy's drinking moonshine? Yeah. Believe me. Okay. All right. Right? That look good?
Mm-hmm.
Right? little close-up.
Oh, I think that looks good. Pizza, though.
All right, let's wrap it and put it away. Gotta get all this. Oh no, I'm gonna have dough hands all night. I think I'll figure it out. Okay, I'll wrap this up, make a drink. Spin that wheel, Ethan. Let's see what we got for another story on there.
I was like, one away from public donor.
Okay. All right, umpiring disaster. This was a disaster. I'm gonna get my cling wrap up, put this in the fridge, and then we'll have the set. Margarita Rob, do you want to be in charge of timing this? Like, I gotta put this in the fridge 20 minutes or so.
Yeah, sure. I'll set a timer on my phone.
Okay, it doesn't have to be that exact. Just rough. You know, sometimes I get lost here. Ethan's bothering me. Just, you know, keep a rough eye on it.
Excuse me?
Don't
forget it. I'm bothered. Okay.
All right, so that's all wrapped up. I'm going to put this in the fridge. Okay. Umpiring disaster. Oh, I get this. I'm such a neat freak. I hate having dirty board. All right. So my first job ever was I was an umpire for Little League, Lexington Little League in Massachusetts. So the first umpiring gig I had was for the playoffs, for like 9-year-old playoffs. And like 9-year-old playoffs, when kids are 9, it's a lot of like dads, a lot of energy into those games, a lot of dads coaching. You know, kids want to win. It's very intense. They only have enough money to pay one umpire though. So you have one umpire and two intense teams going at it for the Little League town playoffs. So that was my first game I ever had to do. Before I went to the game on Saturday, my mom got me an ice cream sundae to celebrate my first job getting paid. This is also a story of how I found out I was lactose intolerant. So I go to the game and things are heating up and there's a lot of rat-a-tat-tat around the third or fourth inning. My stomach is feeling in a way that I've never felt before. Now my mom, I rode my bike there. So, you know, it's not like mom's in the stand can take me home. There's not another umpire. So now there's 6-inning baseball games. The 5th inning, I poop my pants at the game. Okay. Now the parents in the stands directly behind me, were like, oh my God, what is that smell? I'm like, they just laid sod.
Oh no.
It was so embarrassing. And I was like, maybe I just don't have to move. I'll just call everything a strike. Everyone is out. I called this kid out. I called this kid out on like a strikeout. They're like, you only threw 2 balls. I was calling everything a strike. I wanted that game to be over as fast as it possibly could. Parents were getting pissed at me. They're like, that wasn't an out. He was safe by 3 feet. I was like, nah, it doesn't matter. He's out. And then I had to ride my bike home with poop in my pants.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Who wants to get me a sundae?
Is that a punishment?
So, it could be.
Oh, no.
It could be a punishment. All right, now we're going to make a drink, gang. Let's make a drink. I hope after that story, who doesn't have an appetite?
Cooking show.
All right, I just bought this, gang. I don't know if I've talked about this in previous eps, but I didn't have an ice tray until about 3 hours ago. Now I have one. Yeah, it's a big deal for me.
How have you been living all this time?
First time I've ever bought an ice tray, and I have dough all over.
Pop it out like that? Dang.
Yeah, this was a $13 ice tray, okay?
New York City. Crap.
We,
nice.
We have a little snap device here.
You don't just twist them anymore?
You're all bougie, huh?
Bougie ice tray, gang. The ice tray. Okay, we're going to make, I even have this. This is called a...
Bigger. Cup.
A what?
Jigger.
Bigger.
Oh, okay. Bigger.
It's a jigger.
Jiggy has a jigger.
Okay. Jiggier.
Jiggy's jigger.
Okay.
Sound.
We're gonna make this cocktail with Saint Luna Moonshine. So this is my friend's moonshine. It's a local company here in New York. It's actually really good, but it's very potent. So one shot will do me in. All right. So one shot of moonshine. Check. I made this earlier. Jiggy, how do you have all this time? I literally just nap and do this. So this is this is simple syrup, which is just sugar and water, and you boil it. So I'm going to do a little bit of simple syrup. I'm using my jigger right in there. And then we're going to hit it with a little bit of pear juice. I love pear juice. You know, if anyone wants to surprise me with like a bushel of pear juice, I would welcome it. Here we go. Pear juice. One little element of that. What am I missing here? Oh, I gotta do limes. And I also have a little lime squeezer.
I said lime. I said wine. I was like, what?
I said wine.
Okay. Wait, wine.
We're ready to hit it with a little bit of lime juice. Ethan, if you want to hit that misfortune wheel, let's see what the world has in store for us.
Oh, you have people.
With pleasure, Jig.
Oh great, just add more lime juice.
Yeah. Wow.
just add the lime.
Okay. Well, I guess I'll just should I take a bite out of this?
Oh. First bite, Jiggy.
Okay. Lime juice goes in. Lime juice goes in. You take your bite of your lime. Okay, and then I think you gotta stir it up.
That works too.
I'm gonna do something that's like no one's ever seen before. Hold on.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, I can't.
Maybe.
Oh, never mind.
Oh, right there. Oh my God, I can't even tell you. The lime is like coming out of my brain right now. Okay. This is blackberry. It's in my eyeballs, I swear. Blackberry sparkling ice. I'm just gonna hit it with a little bit of top like that, which looks delightful. Then you're gonna take your lime that you took a bite out of. You want to take your bitten lime, be very careful, because this will also act as your garnish.
Wow.
And this, my friends, is a tropical drink for you and yours. And let's do, we'll dedicate it. I swear, my eyes are. Okay. So, this, I'm going to do a shot for, this one goes out to Miss Sarah Watson and Amanda Grebe. Oh, Amanda Grebe is back. Watch out, gang. Amanda Grebe is back in action. All right, so this shot goes out to Sarah Watson and to Amanda Grebe. There you go. Thank you guys for tuning in. Mahalo.
Cheers.
Jump high.
All right. And shout out to Kim Schultz and shout out to Chandler Dunoff, thank you guys. Thank you. Awesome. And let's try the drink.
Just tell.
Like that. That is a delightful beverage. I highly recommend making that at home.
Yeah.
Let's
see. Use more wine.
There's the tour.
Uh-oh. Okay. So I think we got someone to do the song. Do we have Nicole on the line? Bring Nicole on. Is she what? Does she want to come on?
She's on the song. She's on its
place. What's Nicole?
Nicole.
No? Yes. Oh, cool. So I saw, do you want the song or do you want the spins? Do you want to do a combination or both? What?
Whatever you want. I'll definitely take the song.
You'll take the song? The original song? Where's Steve?
I don't know. He was supposed to be up here, but he's maybe falling asleep somewhere. Who knows?
Oh, my God. Sounds like a crowd that usually comes to my shows.
He has all right, 10 so maybe, viewers. so you know he's kind of.
All right, so we're gonna make a. Do you want to make a song about Steve? What are you thinking? What do you want to make a song about? Do you have any initial ideas?
Boy, you're putting me on the spot here.
Well, you know, I mean, you can think about it. If you have like an unruly neighbor, or you have like a kid you don't like, or anything like that, it could be anything.
All right,
You can think about it, but thank you. Thank you so much. That's a big deal. And we'll also do a spin for you too.
All right.
You have something that you want from the wheel?
I didn't really see the wheel well enough, so can I see the wheel?
Yep, Ethan, bring it up for him.
Okay.
Scroll it down.
How about your MJ song?
MJ song, okay. Let me introduce this one. Nicole, this is a good pick. All right, Ethan, do you have this? I was so proud of this in 2007, but no one's really heard it. It's not good. It's not good, but I wasn't doing this to be funny. I really thought this was good.
Was this pre-American Idol audition time or?
Around the same time. Around the same time. I had some delusions about my musical career. Ethan, hit it, play it.
Oh, we're everywhere.
Oh my God.
Yo, 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 yo. You make me feel good, make me feel good. You make me feel good, make me feel good. You make me feel good, make me feel good. You make me feel good, make me feel good. And I remember that first time. You're taking me back to my first rhyme. And you just stood there, running your fingers through your hair. You're looking at me, girl, I just don't care. Then I took you out, put my hand in yours. You're giggling the jokes as I open up doors. We smiling, laughing, walking the streets. Hop in the ride and we blasting the beats. And I knew right then it was meant to be. The feeling got inside and took over me. Then I got home and I couldn't forget that feeling. It's an addiction that's so appealing. Just waiting for that time to pass, to get back to you so that feeling can last. You caused a shock that changed me, girl. I need to get to you because you rock my world. Hey, you make me feel good, make me feel good. You make me feel good, make me feel good. You make me feel good, make me feel good. You make me feel good, make me feel good. And now I'm with you every day. And you still making me feel that special way. Yo, you got me hoping that you're not a heartbreaker. Making all the moves cause I really wanna keep you. And I know sometimes we got our vices, but you keep me happy and higher than gas prices. Lying next to you, I feel like a man. I'm just being myself cause I know.
Nice, I loved it. Fantastic.
Thank you, Nicole.
I feel like that would be like the end credit song of Damn from Myrrh. That would be the song playing at the end credits.
I was so excited. That was the first time I was ever in a recording studio, but leading up to that, I was in my bedroom in the mirror, like, I thought I was going to sign a record deal. I thought I was going to be famous for that. I didn't even do stand-up at the time. I haven't even started doing stand-up.
Oh, it's embarrassing.
Oh, Darren.
When I was toe with Jiggy in the UK, he used to like rollerblade around to Abbo and his headphones for like an hour. I don't know why he's singing that thing. And and the worst thing was he came and slammed his foot down on the tow bus right next to my face and he's like, oh, what's the meaning of life? And it smelled like Parmesan cheese.
Oh, I know. I thought I smelled something at your birthday party dinner, but no one ordered Parmesan cheese.
That's Jiggy.
Gross.
That's Jiggy.
Oh.
Darren, how excited are you for the book launch?
I'm very excited. How's it going, Chief?
Doing pretty well. Is that a cat you have, or is that a lion? What is that?
This is Morris. He's the lion. Oh, I'm sorry for lifting him up by that, but yeah, he's our lion protector. He protects Maple and
He looks very serious. You know, we're trying to do a very lighthearted comedy event, and Morris is taking this a little serious.
I'm sorry. I mean, we're just enjoying your show with a few drinks there, and Jiggy, you're doing a great job, and Ethan is too.
Thank you so much, Darren. Cheers. Listen, if you want to, do you want to read one sentence? This would be funny. Do you want to read one sentence with no context from the new book?
I could do that.
Author.
What you'll do, what we'll do is we'll go through the book and flip the pages. I'll tell you to stop, and then you just pick one random line, one sentence.
Right. Yeah. Jen's giving me a book. I will do this. Say stop.
Yep. You ready? Tell me when. Stop.
Okay.
And then run your fingers through the page.
Okay. And then fingers through
the page. Run your fingers through the page and stop.
And stop. In the distance, the sound of "Working My Way Back to You" by the Spinners erupted from the far side of the ship.
Yes. I can't wait to find out the context of that.
Pulitzer Prize winning. Pulitzer Prize winning. I'm hooked.
Thank you, sir.
I'm hooked.
Thank you.
Well, you're in the book, Jiggy.
I don't think I'm in this one.
No, Jiggy's already dead.
Yeah, you're already dead. What are you talking about?
Yeah, hold off. This is the new novel, which, unless I'm resurrected from the dead, you know.
Where's the end, Jiggy?
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Bring me back from the dead. You never know, Darren. He doesn't want to give away any secrets. But you
A girl never gives away any secrets, Jiggy.
All right. Well, you're going to hang out for the show. You're going to see how I do this pasta?
Yeah, of course we are. I mean, your cooking is the best. The best thing on the Practical Jokers cruise is Jiggy's cooking and his mimosas.
Ah, thank you. I appreciate that. Thanks. All right. Well, I'm going to do a couple of shout outs here, Darren. Happy Father's Day to all the dads in the world. That's from Deborah Gula. Thank you. That's a good message to have. Thank you, Deborah. AJ Flick, all the way from Arizona. Shout out to Jiggy, Rob Emmer, and the other IJ Cruisers. I think we have some IJ Cruisers on here, and that's from AJ Flick. Laura Gentile, thanks for continuing to bring us all the much laughter. Hashtag Boston love. Love the Boston love. Thank you, Laura. And Diane Abbott says, my birthday was June 16th. Since I've been quarantined, it would be great to hear happy birthday from you. Well, here it is. Happy birthday, Diane, to you. It's a few days late, but I hope that you've been waiting for this moment to celebrate it. Happy birthday, Diane. There you
happy
go.
Birthday, Diane.
Happy birthday, Diane. Also want to give a big shout out to Bonnie Goodhart. Bonnie Goodhart, she was on the last show. She sent a nice contribution. She doesn't want a wheel spin, but if she wants to come up and say hello, is Bonnie here? Is she watching? Is Bonnie here? Oh, there she is. Bonnie, how are you? You're on mute. You got to demute. You got it.
You'd never know I was a tech coordinator for my school district.
Oh, see? You can't trust the tech people. Never can test them. What do you think of the drink so far? Doesn't this look tropical? Do you feel
it does look it looks delicious. I don't like rum, long story, but that I would give that a try.
This is the moonshine. There's moonshine in there.
And I can get you direct from a DEA agent from the Georgia Appalachians if you need to.
I've never said no to moonshine.
I want your head scratching me so much.
Yeah, man.
I need to know those
DEA
secrets.
DEA moonshine?
Yeah, he shared.
Fun story. You're muted again. What happened?
I can hear.
Send me, and I will send you guys some DEA confiscated food traffic.
I hope the DEA is the name of the brand. It comes with DEA brand.
Literally. I live in Georgia, therefore NASCAR, therefore Appalachian Mountains, therefore straight from the stealth.
Tons of moonshine. Okay. Mm-hmm. Did you want to pick something from the story wheel?
Yeah, I would love to pick something from the story wheel.
All right.
I'm going to go with the chocolate. What did you say your favorite was? The chocolate raspberry one?
Chocolate raspberry ball sauce. That's a fun tale. Okay, and I'm gonna try to get this board cleaned as I tell this story. I think some people have heard it on here, but one of my favorite stories was, it's actually the first online date I've ever done. Let's see. was on
like online, as in like Tinder online or like comedy online?
No, this was like an online date where I met the girl on OkCupid.com, which is a free online dating site. And this was in 2009. So you only had one profile picture. It was a real crapshoot what was going to show up on the date for her and for me. So I met this girl. She looked cute on there. I was like, boom, let's go on a date. Took her down Park Avenue, Winter Park, Florida. Had some nice, had a couple of drinks. I'm thinking, this girl's cute. And she invited me back to her apartment. So I go back to her apartment and things are like heating up. She starts kissing on my neck, nibbling on my ears. So you know what happens next. Darren. Okay. Darren has a kid. He knows what I'm talking about. Right? Darren's made a child. He gets it. So this girl is like, I got to go get something from my room. So as a guy in that situation, I'm thinking, ooh, maybe she is going to go get some like sexy outfit and try to impress me. No. She comes back from her room wearing all the same stuff, but carrying her purse from the date. So she sits down next to me and opens up her purse and she brings out this little jar. And I'm like, what the hell is that? And she said something I never heard before or since. She whispered into my ear. She said, this is chocolate raspberry ball sauce. I'm thinking, chocolate raspberry ball sauce on a first date? 3 hours ago, this girl didn't even know my first name. She just knew me by my screen name, which was Jiggy Me J, 21. And now she's busting out chocolate raspberry ball sauce. What's that? Who's alarms going on?
That is the alarm.
Pasta.
Pasta.
Gotta get the pasta out.
Thank you,
buddy. So she busts out this sauce on me. And a lot of things were going through my head. Like, who carries around chocolate raspberry ball sauce on a first date? You know, and the other thing that was going through my mind was that was in her purse the entire time. She brought that to Chili's.
She was prepping.
This girl knew what she was doing. Now, some of the guys, Rob, Darren, are thinking, that sounds like a pretty cool date. It sounds like a pretty cool first date. And it could have been, but as she opened up the container, I realized it wasn't even a new jar.
Oh, God.
This girl was dipping. So we did it for 3.5 years.
I'll buy that one for my next date.
Did you at least get a new ball jar after that first date?
Yeah, there you go. It's chocolate raspberry ball sauce story, and that's all true. And actually, before I moved to New York 7 years ago, I had to sell my car down in Florida, and I was waiting outside Publix, which is a supermarket down there, where they're going to pick it up on the truck. And I was sitting out there waiting for them to pick it up. My flight was the next day to move to New York. And who comes out of Publix with a friggin' chicken tender sub? The chocolate raspberry ball sauce girl. That was the last person I saw in Florida before I
moved. It is okay. Florida.
Yeah, that's true. It is Florida.
I resent
people
that.
People wonder why Corona's jumping up down there again.
They are in the ball.
Okay. All right. Now we're going to start the point of the show where things could get bad.
That doesn't
I'm
happen.
Gonna try to roll this out on my thing here.
Give it a good try.
Give it a good slap.
Flour on the wheel, right? Flour on the bun. All right, Rob. You know, 39 years ago when you did this, any tips?
Like I said, it was gnocchi, so we made little pieces and just rolled them into dumplings. So we didn't have to cut it in the pasta cutter. But as long as the dough is settled, you should be fine. Jenny says she has a tip. Buy
What's
it.
The tip? Oh, it's not anchored down.
It's like rolling fondant.
Why do you put it in a pencil sharpener?
Congratulations, oh, no, you made a pancake. You made a flatter.
No! Okay, all right.
All right, so you're flattened down.
So that's, I'd say that's a pretty shitty start. not the best start, but. So now we just have to keep on increasing the wheel size, right?
Mm-hmm. Thinning out more and more with each roll.
Okay. All right. You want to hold the wheel, Reed? All right.
That's nice.
Ooh. Nice. All right. Now we got to do one more. Guys, I feel like I'm in Italy. Ethan, you can roll the story wheel if you want.
Cool.
Look, have you ever seen this move? The little bracing move? Okay. What is this one? I hate the dentist. Oh, okay. Good one. I do hate the dentist. All right, we got one more. I hate the dentist because my mom's a dental hygienist, and she always is using me as, like, experiments, like, when they get new equipment at the dentist office. And she's a pediatric dental hygienist, so I've been going to, like, the same office since I was, like, 4. And I still go there, and like little kids are next to me and like crying, and I'm hanging off the end. I'm like 33 years old, hanging off the chair, still crying too with my little sunglasses on. And I don't like when they talk. I came up with the most brilliant idea. I gave this to my mom. She never ran with it. When the dentist talked to you, all I need to have is they have a little sign next to the chair, okay? They have a sign next to the chair, that one side is green and one side is red, and it says yes or no. And then they ask you yes or no questions, and you hold up the sign and you can answer questions all night.
That's smart.
Guys, mic drop. That's like the best idea in dentistry. You know what my mom said? I don't know. Okay, here we go. I need like dramatic music when I'm trying to Is that Rob whistling?
Yes, it's me whistling.
It can work.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god, I feel like I'm in Venice. Stop it, Rob.
It's the Godfather, man.
I think we got to go one more time here.
You could chop it.
Okay.
You could chop it in half.
All right. My sous chef here is telling me I could just chop it in half. Okay. Good move there. Add a little bit more flour.
Which type of pasta are you shooting for, Jiggy?
What?
What are you doing? Fettuccine? Are you doing linguine?
I think we're going to do a little, I think it's fettuccine, but to be honest with you, Rob, I don't friggin' know.
I think it's skinny enough.
No, we got to do one more. You got to go every setting. What do you think this is?
Well, depends on the pasta that you're making. You don't necessarily have to do every setting.
Yeah.
Rob, never disagree with me ever again.
Okay, I won't disagree with you. I'm sorry.
Okay. Oh no, I didn't put it in straight. Oh crap. This is where I screwed up last time. Okay, buongiorno. Alright. This is a little bit fat on this side here. A little bit too fat. But damn it, did I screw this up? Okay. All right. Well, I'm going to, this is harder than it looks. All right. So I'm going to cut this and then try to motion it through my other wheel here. See, this is not right. I'm going to try to make it so it
fits. What kind of pasta are we making? Are we making like spaghetti or what?
Well, yeah, I'm going to run it through the other side. I'm not going to use a lasagna sheet. Come on, Beatrice.
you can get creative.
All right.
Shrimp's going to be like little lasagna things.
Now I'm going to, you got to change the gear here. Okay, and then you run it through this one.
It's very short pasta.
Listen, it's my first attempt. Oh, let's grease the wheels here. A little bit of flour. Okay. This is hard to get in.
Meanwhile,
dance break.
What does it say?
Dance break, Jig.
Oh, dance break. Where's Justin?
Not there.
We got it.
You change it.
No, we'll do this setting. Okay. We're gonna wait for text Justin. We'll do a dance break. Hold on. This is so frustrating. Why didn't I just use... Hold on. I'm on the wrong gear. What a disaster. Hold on.
Okay, there you go.
It looks good, man. Just stay patient. You're good.
This is better. This is the one I should have done.
Ooh, there you go.
Like magic.
That's nice.
What's this? Scraps? Okay. That's a little bit of this. That will go into my scrap pile. This is all the failures. This one I'm going to do for Rob. I'm going to put this one through. This is the heavier, this is the thicker sheet here. Okay. Oh, the thicker sheet, I think, was the way to go.
I told you.
Rob's never been wrong.
Trust me, I've been wrong plenty of times. Just ask my wife.
Okay. That looks good, right?
Yeah.
That looks wonderful.
One serving. Congratulations.
How much shrimp did you get for this again?
I got a half pound of shrimp. I don't know. I gotta make some more. I got more dough here. Lay off me.
Right. Got enough for two servings there.
Got enough. Yeah, this is a nice little chunk. I floured it so it would just stay right there. We'll move over to this other thing. Let me know when we have Justin and we'll do a little dance break.
Yep, he's
a
popping
KitchenAid off. KitchenAid with a pasta attachment.
Oh, that's true. That would be a lot easier, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
This one isn't. Oh, it's too sticky.
Oh no.
Oh no. Darren! Oh, it's all sticky.
Flour it up a little bit more and reshape it.
Shit, I should have put flour on
it. It got warm sitting on the counter, that's all.
Yeah.
It was my fault.
No one's your fault there. That's just the law.
It's always one of our faults.
Yeah.
It's always your fault.
Thank you.
Oh no!
That's okay, common to you.
We'll save this for another day.
You put it in the fridge for about 5 minutes. You should
put it back in the fridge.
Put this back in the fridge or this?
No, put the lump back in the fridge.
Yeah.
Oh, the lump.
Put the clump back in the fridge for a few minutes. Let it harden back up again. Then it'll flatten out nicer.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the yeast. This isn't good. Let me remind you can tip at Jiggy Comedy. Just a friendly reminder. Friendly reminder there. I hope that this comes out. I hope this comes out of the machine. Oh, that actually helped.
Careful.
I hope it didn't ruin my machine. Well, whatever. Where's Justin?
I gave that to you.
Where's Justin?
He's coming. Not here yet. We got that dance break.
Dance break! You made pasta!
Hey!
Sorry.
Whoa, what are you doing?
Is anyone else dancing? Dance break over. Great job. Thanks, Justin. I'm gonna flour this and fridge it for another time. But I think this would be enough for the serving that we're. I'm out of breath, out of shape. I haven't been working out a lot. Rob, you have a couple spins. You can pick something from the misfortune or the story wheel. What do you want?
Well, I think.
Let's bring Rob up.
Everybody,
you wanna come up?
What's that?
You want to come on?
Sure.
Yeah, bring him on. Where's Ethan?
What's Rob under?
I think I'm actually under unknown host for some reason.
Interesting.
Your name is unknown host in this thing?
Yes, my name today is unknown host. There I am.
Oh, all the way from the tropics. Oh.
Yeah, I wish. It's all the way from my kitchen.
All right. So what would you like to see, Rob?
I think I've had this song in my head.
Oh, my God.
And it's about a time travel device that comes from a very special place. And I think we need another verse to a butthole time machine.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Well, I've waited my whole life for this. I don't remember how the first one went. But I think it was something almost to the tune of, it was butthole time machine, a butthole time machine. Everybody wants it. Everybody needs it. If you time travel, this is the device for you. If you have a butt too, you can use it too. Butthole time machine, it comes from your rear end. Butthole time machine, what is happening fun? Butthole time machine. Butthole time machine. Rob has a butt. Rob has a machine. Rob has a time machine. All right, Rob.
Come on, everyone. Give him a hand. Just go put the hand by his butt. That's all.
We need another word.
Rob has a butt. Rob has a machine. Rob has a butt. All right, I'm going to start heating my water up to boil my dang things. Water on. Just like in Italy, Rob, you got to put olive oil. Oh, let's go down to chop. Let's go down to, can you get the cam down here, Ethan? Let's use it.
Yep.
Can you see me down there? Okay.
Yep.
Just put a little olive oil in there. A little bit of salt.
Are you into the rest of the pasta?
No, just that. Okay.
You should do the rest.
All right, I'm going to boil the water. Now I'm going to make shrimp scampi. So I'm going to put this off to the side, my little pasta nuggets. You guys see the water about to boil. All right, you can come back to the regular can here.
Sorry, I'm chatting with all these people.
Okay. All right, as you can see, I have some lovely shrimp. Everybody go, ooh.
Ooh.
Everybody go, ah.
Ooh, ah.
Most half enthusiastic crowd ever. These are shrimp. I'm gonna make this the best shrimp pasta with, I don't even know if this is enough pasta for this dish, but we're gonna try it out. So first we gotta season it.
Wait, are you gonna do half pound of shrimp for a
yes.
quarter cup of pasta?
Yep. That's all gonna be different. Season this thing up. We're gonna olive oil them. put in some pepper. I think we have my buddy, is Mike Charette on?
Yep.
Ethan, is Mike there?
He was.
What happened? He probably has a bad connection from Vegas.
Unless he changed his name.
Could have changed his name.
He came in as Mike Charette, though.
Maybe he changed it. He's been looking for a name change. In the meantime, we could do some shout outs. Thank you guys for hitting up the tip line. It's at Jiggy Comedy at Jiggy Comedy for Venmo or PayPal. And if you're on trying to do the PayPal, it's jiggyandjohn@gmail is the email account. Let's do some, what do we have? Oh, Rick Warren, tip jar for Rick Carpenter. Friday tip jar, Rick Carpenter. I don't know who Rick Carpenter is, but
check
Rick Warren, maybe it's like multiple names. So shout out for him. We do have some karaoke songs, so you're going to be getting songs from me tomorrow for Heather Dugan, Heather, Helen Galuzzo, and Joy. You guys have songs coming your way for tomorrow. And Beth Rollinger. Oh, we got a shot. I knew Beth was on the
show. You know it.
It wasn't a shotgun beer, though.
I'm not. It's too early.
Oh, later.
Too early. She knows how it goes. She knows how
too
it goes.
Too early well. To shotgun.
That's right, Jiggy.
Beth, this goes to you. Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, Beth.
Thank you. Cheers, y'all.
Come by.
Okay. Oh, do we just get another one from MB Collins? Well, we got to do it. Another shot for MB. I don't know what MB stands for. Maybe Mary Beth?
Ooh. Oh, possibly.
Maybe. Could be making that up. MB Collins, shot goes to you. This is, I don't even know, my third or fourth?
Let's take
cheers, thank you. And we also have a shout out to Kelsey Gerhardt. I think I did that, pronounce it right. Thank you. Thank you very much. And let's see. Any more shout outs? Let's see. Oh, Nicole, you have another wheel? Is that right?
Yes.
All right, Nicole.
Rob had two.
And Rob, you have another one. You're not off the hook yet. You have another one too. All right, Nicole, what do you got for me off the wheel? Could be either one.
Actually, could you want to have some of those peanuts?
Oh.
it's your thing. Do I want to have these peanuts that I've been dreading for 3 weeks? I mean, I can think of other things. Is this what you would like? Where's Nicole? Bring her back up. These are, honestly, this is almost as hot as that hot wing sauce. It's oh, Steve comes back.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Steve's taking a nap in the garage. Then he finally makes it back. No chance he wasn't taking a nap in the garage. All right. So you want peanuts from hell?
Yes.
Yes.
Peanuts from hell.
Okay.
Because all right. We love you.
All right, I'm going to pour these out, too, so you can see how ruthless they are. Shout out to Beatrice for sending these, too. There you go. Can you see how thickly coated they are?
Mm-hmm.
These are brutal. Okay, here we go. One mouthful. Nicole, thank you. You have a song. Beautiful song coming for Steve. Does Steve know about the song yet?
He does not know about the song yet.
Hey, Jig, before you do that, look at your phone.
What do you know? Okay. All right. Well, I think we have a guest coming in. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll bring them on if they're ready.
All right. We're getting there.
We're getting there. This is going to be a tough one. I'm nursing my pasta over here. Oh, look who it is.
Mr. Hi.
Hello.
David,
thank you so much for coming on to the show. This is a comedy has a big spectrum. This is as low as it goes. You know, you're a legend. You do not have to be here.
No, I appreciate, you know, coming down a long way to do this. So I'm here. Yeah.
So just to keep you up to speed, what we've been doing, I've been attempting to cook. I made homemade pasta, which that's impressive. Yeah. And right now I'm about to eat the world's hottest peanuts.
Okay, what is the ultimate goal here? Is a pizza or something?
The ultimate goal is to pay rent, basically. We have Nicole who's on here, and she dared me to eat these hot peanuts. I'm going to be trying to make a shrimp scampi at some point. Okay. I have these shrimps here. But okay. You said you're not much of a cook, David. Have you ever made shrimp scampi before?
No, I've really never made anything. I haven't.
You've made some great movies.
Yeah. I'm okay at the movies, but you know, I can make cereal. I can make eggs. I can break eggs. I can break an egg with one hand. You know that I can do that, and I can make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and I pour my cereal.
Crusty's on, crusty's off.
What'd you say?
Are you doing crusty's on or crusty's off with the peanut butter and jelly?
I eat the whole thing. I don't
the whole thing.
I like, yeah. You know, when I used to make, I actually could make that for my kids when they were little, and my son always wanted me to, you know, take the crust off. But, you know, he's 20 now, so he can
take his own crust off, really.
He's come a long way, yeah.
Is he going for a career in entertainment as well? I mean, look how far it can take you.
My advice is always, you know, quit now, you'll never make it. But he's majoring in communications at the University of Wisconsin.
Woo! So, oh, cool.
So he's enjoying it. And, you know, as long as he loves it, it's fine. At first, I really did discourage him, but because it's so stupidly impossible that, but I don't want to encourage anybody. And, you know, you won't catch me saying, you can do it, you know.
Well, don't start tonight, please.
Yeah.
This is where, you know, I'd love to learn some writing tips about movies, because this is where my stand-up career is right now. I'm about to eat hot peanuts trying to make shrimp scampi. It's not going.
All right, well, I'll do the best I can with what I have to work with.
I'm gonna jump in, try to eat these. I'm telling you, these are mind-blowingly spicy.
Okay, you know, they look like dried apricots, which are my favorite.
Ooh, I love a good dried apricot.
Yeah.
Oh,
those are carrots though, right?
No, these are the world's hot, these are peanuts from hell.
Oh, okay, I can't tell anything. I everything looks different to me, like, yeah. But I'll take your word for it, those are carrots, okay.
Do you want, you need these?
I have them, I have my own. And these are the best I can get at the local pharmacy, because I used to actually have them made at my ophthalmologist, and it just, I keep losing them, so I don't pay any money for these. Are like $6.95.
Really, you can have a
dollar store.
All right, well, here we go. Thank you, David. Thank you for coming on the show. I really, really appreciate it. You're an inspiration. I hope one day that I can have a breadth of work that's one-tenth of what you have. Until then, I'll be making shrimp scampi in my kitchen.
I appreciate that, and I appreciate your having me on. Thanks, and it really looks good what you're doing. So what do I know?
Thank you. Here we go.
Okay. Okay, yes, here we go. Jeez.
Ugh.
Here we go.
Chuck.
Where's your cocktail?
Yeah, where is my cocktail?
This is his monthly trip to the emergency room.
Moonshine and hot peanuts.
Mmm.
The dinner of champions.
This is like that show that I watch. My son told me about this show where a guy, they eats really spicy foods, and they keep doing more spicy.
Hot ones.
Yeah.
Chicken wing one?
That's right, yeah. And the guy has different guests on, and
yeah.
I don't know how to do that. Yeah.
David, I'm a hack. You know, this has all been done before.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're all hoping you can get up to the level of appearing on. That would be great. And then I'll look forward to watching that. Can I have my martini now?
Yes.
Here, Ethan, let's impress David. Show us camera two. We even have multiple angles on this. Show camera two.
Yeah.
Look at that frying pan action.
Water's boiling.
Jiggy, David doesn't look that impressed.
I stopped paying attention about 2 minutes ago. I'm waiting for my martini.
All right.
Really, so during this quarantine, I've had at 5 o'clock, I have my martini with, you know, a friend or even alone. It's even more pathetic to drink alone, and that's what I've been doing a lot. And so I've been doing. I have a Bombay and Lillet martini, a little bitters, and I've learned how to make a few things. So that's about the most interesting thing I've been doing. In addition to, I've been building a treehouse in my backyard. So that
I made this moonshine. I mean, this is a moonshine pear thing. That's good. It's this moonshine. Good. It's actually, I recommend it. I think they sell it in California, St. Luna Moonshine, but it's got a lot of kick in it. And you can replace gin with this and just gives a little, get a little extra.
Okay, so moonshine is just regular whiskey. Are you okay?
I'm okay. A peanut just in my throat.
I don't want to be involved in any news article beginning. Apparently, yeah.
It's 50% alcohol. It's molasses and rye.
Did you? Oh, good. Did you pour in the all those ingredients that I have? Good. Because this is good. Yeah. Thanks.
Oh, yes. With a twist. All right.
Yeah. This is. Because I made enough for Robbie too, in my glass. It was all in the glass.
That I didn't do that.
Oh my God!
I made a new one.
You made a new. Okay, that's okay.
That's why.
Yeah, this is. You can cut this part out, right? Thanks. Good. Okay.
David, we're live.
So yeah.
As the same witnesses.
This is great. Okay. Thank
what
you.
If I just take a whole corner? It's like a giant. Close up.
It is giant.
Cheers.
It's good.
Cheers.
Cheers, yeah.
Cheers, David. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you very much. Now I can start drinking in earnest. Thank you for having me. Good to see you again. Bye-bye.
Great
thank
to
see you.
Hi, David.
Hi, David.
Bye. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
All right. David Zucker, you never know who's going to come. Legendary director.
That's awesome.
That was awesome.
That was so cool, Jiggy.
How cool is that? I do not deserve that. He's literally a legend. I have to take this pasta out. I put the pasta in the pan, in the boiling water. But it cooks so quickly that I'm going to take it out because I think it's done. I'm out. I'm fine.
I'm sorry. Want to test one?
No. I don't.
Throw it against the wall, see if it sticks.
Usually by 11 minutes, fettuccine.
I stole my door.
Move to chop cam.
Oh my God, let's throw the chop cam.
Ethan, how dare you?
Sorry, I was texting David.
Okay. So I have my pasta. It came out of the water there.
Well, now you're in the wrong can.
Oh, I'm in the wrong can.
There you go. Ew, it's delicious.
That looks good.
All right. So I got my pan heated up, gang. I got oil and butter. Can't go wrong with that to start. Now, I'm going to... let me check. See if we have a... Do we have any more shout-outs here? I just want to make sure.
Shout-out.
Oh, Joy Lewis. Thank you. Shout-out to Joy Lewis.
Messages
we have. Oh, Rob Emmer's on the line, playing a little game called Just a Tip from Rob Emmer. Thank you for contributing. And Teresa Doster, thanks, Jiggy. Darren, I have a book question and sent you a message. Oh, watch out. Darren, keep an eye on your messages. Teresa has got one for you.
Rob's got another deal.
Answer.
I don't know.
So we need some lemon juice and lemon zest. This is going to be, that's the most important part of this thing. So I'm going to get some lemon zest while that heats up.
Someone choose sour face.
Oh, God.
Sorry, Jiggy.
I'm surprised no one's doing the shotgun ones. That's like,
I'm not waiting. Just saying.
It's what? Coming, Jiggy. I'm waiting.
You're waiting until I'm like drunk or until the show's over.
Do it now. Beth and I are waiting.
I'm doing it now. Beth is doing it now.
Go, Beth. I'll support you in this. All
right. Lemon zest. Oh, yeah. Okay.
I put shotgun.
All right. So I'm going to get some lemon juice ready to roll using my little lemoner. Oh, I didn't capture one of the seeds. Crap. A lot of lemon juice. Okay. Got the lemon juice, got the lemon zest. I'm going to cut a couple lemon wheels to go in. This is one of my favorite things to make in the world. Not the fresh pasta part, but okay.
The pasta looks great.
Thank you. All right. So we're going to go in with my shrimp. This is going to cook pretty quick. Turn down the heat. Oh no. Okay. Did I mention we do private events? All right, turn down the heat. It's too hot.
Can you do the other cam?
Cook, where's the pan?
Oh, cooking cam. There you go.
Yay.
Oh, that looks good.
Okay.
They do cook fast.
Turn down the heat. We gotta add. What are we gonna do now? Drunk. Okay, we gotta add red pepper flakes. A few of those.
Who's yawning?
Who's yawning? Who's yawning?
Who is yawning?
Not I, says the fly.
Oh, David's here? Bring on David. Does David want to come on? Ethan, bring on David too.
Show him your cocktail with the moonshine.
Oh, there he is. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the creator of St. Luna Moonshine. David Soup, live from the store. Are you unmuted?
Need a tasting.
Can we hear you? I can't hear you. Oh, there you go. There you go. So what'd you think? How'd I do with this cocktail?
I think you did great. I want to try it with the blackberry soda.
Well, I don't know if I'm going to give you the recipe, but we can talk about it.
I might be able to figure it out.
And what do you know? David Zucker knows about St. Luna now.
I thought that was pretty cool.
Oh shit, I forgot the garlic, David. You didn't remind me.
Sure. It looks pretty good though.
Could use the pre-cut ones.
Okay. I don't want to use the pre-cut ones. I don't want my shrimps to overcook, but David, how are you doing over there?
I'm doing pretty good.
Do you have a drink?
I do. I'm drinking wine, though.
Wine?
I know. I drank all the St. Luna yesterday.
Have you ever made homemade pasta? Did you see me make the homemade pasta? Did it get a David approval?
It did. You know, I've done it a couple times, but I've got the pasta crank that goes on the KitchenAid.
Yes.
Oh, God. Everyone's showing off about that.
Yeah, like the old school pasta crank is too hard.
Yeah, it's tough. But listen, I think we made the best of it. I forgot to do this garlic part, which is a big, big element of this dish. All right.
I think it's going to taste great.
Okay. And I think Beatrice has a spin, if I'm not mistaken. Beatrice, how did I miss you? Where's B?
Right here, dude. Been here the whole time.
Where'd you send it? We missed you.
About 25 minutes ago. It's not my fault you ignore me.
Okay. What would you like, B?
The decisions is tempting. I got two choices. Either the magic mic thing or either the plastic hand. What do you guys think?
Magic mic.
Magic mic.
I'm convinced. I'm easily persuaded.
We got to get Justin Gerace back on for that. In the meantime, I want to do some shout outs. So shout outs to Heather McKinney. Thank you. I have a Do You Believe in Love by Huey Lewis that's going to be going out tomorrow from A Touch of Crafts. Touch of Crafts. I like that. Thank you. You'll see me tomorrow. Oh, Kelly Hutton has a spin of the wheel. So if you can remember that, Ethan, Kelly Hutton has a spin of the wheel. And also, there we go, Beatrice. And let's see. Happy birthday. Happy birthday from all of her Twitter friends. Happy birthday, Melissa. Woo-hoo! From Wendell Gibson.
Yes, thank you.
Happy birthday, Melissa.
Thank you.
And a happy birthday to Kelly Hutton. It's, we have a birthday for Kelly, too. And we got to get Pony Lock signed up for Justin to play.
Oh, I have that, Jig. I have that.
Oh, you have that. Okay. Well, let's do one thing. I don't want to overcook the shrimp. Hold on. Let me see.
Where's the cameras?
The other cam. Can we get it on the other cam?
Oh, yeah, let's get the other. Yep. This looks actually pretty freaking
fancy. Well, that's only the
shrimp. Shrimp stamping.
Now, putting the lemon zest in. And I'm going to put the GA, a little bit of that. This looks freaking awesome.
Does look really good.
All right, here we go.
Uh-oh. All right.
That's what I can do.
I am impressed.
Is it Bobby Ray's kitchen in here or what?
Bring in the flip.
Okay, so we're going to let that settle. Ethan, if you got the song.
Why you no wear shoes? Where's your shoes, dude?
Good choice, babe.
Yeah, I'm just compensating for the fact that I haven't seen the show with that in a freaking long ass time.
Guys, are we going to see Jiggy wax himself tonight?
Please.
I don't know. Are we?
I don't know. I'm not quite sure if I want to.
Oh, we want to see that. So please keep them coming.
I know. I've done leg waxing before. It's not fun.
How much more do we need?
You can hit it whenever you're ready, Ethan.
But how much?
I'm hitting.
Are you doing the light? Oh God, no! And I'm right.
Yeah,
weird
lighting.
Oh,
I don't want to
shout.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
Sexable in here or something?
Hi, Darren.
Oh, chicken did his best. That was good. Sexy.
That was awesome.
Hot. I'm extremely tired.
You turned me on, Jiggy.
Mission accomplished.
Hey. That was the goal. Whew. Okay. I'm really out of breath.
That's impossible.
I wish I could have captured you guys' reaction. I mean, that was a premeditated shirt cut into a shirt rip. Okay, that didn't just happen by accident. Shout out to Julia Patton. Thank you, Julia. Hope you enjoyed the dance.
David, I did.
Thank you. David Sue contributing. Thank you with the message of shrimp. And Paul Sikaitis, too legit to kick to life. You may want to invest in a small cutting board for your bar lines. That's very actually true. Oh God, I'm out of breath. I wasn't built for this. Do we have any more shots? I'm glad I did that towards the end.
Time for another shot.
Oh, Beth, Rolinger, I'm assuming that you have something I know that you want me to do. Where's Beth? Bring her up.
I'm right here. Hi.
Okay, Beth. What can I do for you, Beth?
You know what you want. You know it, right?
Just girl.
Shotgun.
Woo! That girl.
I see the shotgun. Just one.
Just one.
He's like, no.
Now, do it correctly this time, Jiggy.
What? I don't know what do it correctly, do it incorrectly. I'm out here trying my best.
Come on, Cubs boy. Let's go.
Wow. That was aggressive.
Those are my keys. Oh,
so cool.
She's not very happy. All right, hold
I connected
on.
My
come on, boy.
Lens to
go.
My...
Here we go.
Here's.
You guys ready?
Here we go.
This one's
cheers,
for Beth.
Jiggy.
Thank you.
Here we go. This one's for Beth.
All right, Beth.
Yeah.
Had a girl.
Oh. Thank you. No
How
more.
Many more of those do you have, Jiggy?
What?
How many more of those do you have?
One more.
Oh, come on. We got to get the money going here.
I got one more beer left.
Got to get Brian to give you more.
Nicole, does Nicole have another one? Nicole, you have a spin too. Oh, there's Mike Charette.
Hey, we're here.
Hey, Mike.
Mike, did you see my strip?
I think I caught the end of it.
That's
hilarious.
That's probably for the best for our friendship.
I think so.
How about this dish? Mike, look at this thing.
Yum.
How good is that
what
look?
What you making there, bro? A little shrimp scampi?
Shrimp scampi homemade pasta? What? I'm like,
oh.
Crazy talk.
Jiggy, can you do like a pasta flip?
Yeah, I can do a pasta flip. What do you think this is?
All right, let's see it.
You ready? Here, can you tilt the camera down a little?
Oh, God. Okay. I might have just ruined you guys' show.
This pasta flip is for my friend Michael. Ready? It's on the wrist.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Nice.
Impressive.
Oh, okay.
I mean, it wasn't like an Olive Garden commercial pasta flip.
Michael, you know, don't kick me when I'm down. I'm just strip teased. I can't believe no one's done the wig. I thought this was going to be the first thing to go.
Don't ruin what I was planning on doing.
I have my priorities.
And just to remind you, I have face tattoos. I have nails. I have this fake hair that which I would put on my head. I mean, guys, I have loaded this thing up. I Amazoned a lot. Nicole, what would you like to see?
Well, it's actually a Father's Day gift for Steven, so I'll let him.
Okay.
I think the face tattoo.
There you go.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, face tattoo.
I would kind of laugh a little bit if it was like Father's Day gift, strip again.
Well, since it's
face strip for daddy.
Oh, well.
You want a snake? Or
center of his forehead?
I have a skull and bone.
That's the dark mark.
What should I say? Yeah, Harry Potter.
Words. What are you thinking? What do you want to see? I got this.
Oop.
This one. Oh, I got a Playboy one.
Yeah, Playboy one, definitely.
And where would you want it on my face?
I think right in your forehead.
Yes. Yeah. Hand right back.
I was thinking, oh, Steve's on my side. You know, I'm going to get it on my fucking neck.
Oh, no.
Cool. No, Steve goes on my forehead. We're knowing. That person gets a fucking forehead tattoo. I have to go to Starbucks tomorrow morning for coffee.
Oh, okay. I used to have a forehead. Now I have a 5-head. All
right, so I think I put this. I had to get a wet rag. Okay. I haven't done a lip tattoo in a long time. Does it have to be warm or?
No.
Okay. All right. Well, Steve, happy Father's Day. I hope one day I have a child and this is what I get for Father's Day.
Jiggy is putting a temporary face tattoo on right
now. How long are you supposed to hold it on here for?
I don't know, but get your screenshots ready.
Spin the story wheel, Ethan. I can't even talk. I'm drunk. Spin the story wheel while we're waiting.
And you have another one left over from Rob.
Yeah, and Rob, you have one more too.
What is this technology?
Dream girl from David.
Okay. So in high school, I was obsessed with these two girls. They were identical twins. They were, I don't want to tell you their last name, but they were identical, Brianna and Lauren, identical twins. And they were cheerleaders, and I had no way of, I was too scared to talk to them, even though they were 2 years younger than me. I was a senior, they were sophomores. And my whole goal was to ask one of them out to the prom. So what I did is they were cheerleaders for the basketball team. So my only way in, because I was too small and not good at basketball, is I became the DJ for the basketball team. Now, what is a high school basketball DJ? No one actually knows. I didn't do anything. I sat and I played music at halftime. And then when they came out and they, like, all the cool kids were like dunking and shit, I was playing, "This is how we do it." I thought that was gonna help me. So anyway, I knew that they were looking at me across the court, so I knew I had some eyeballs on me. I even made a shirt. It said St. Andrew School DJ, and it said Jiggy on the side. So I had some cred at the high school. So in passing to classes, she was walking towards me. I never spoke to her in my entire life. And I said, "Hey, Lauren, I was just wondering if you would want to go to the prom with me." And she said, "Yes." And I had the best fucking day ever. I was calling all my friends on the baseball team, "You'll never nest. Lauren's going to go to the prom with me." Everyone's so impressed. One of the twins was going with me to the prom. So that weekend, we went and we stayed at one of our friends' condos in the Florida Keys. And we went down there and we were celebrating. Everyone thought that I was like the coolest kid in school. I had the hottest date to prom. And her friend called me. I'll never forget it. Jessica calls me that Saturday night. It wasn't even 48 hours into celebrating. Jessica calls me. It's an unknown number, 561 Boca number. I answer it. I'm like three beers deep, so I'm fucking hammered. I answer the phone and she goes, "Hi, this is Jessica. Is this Jiggy?" Yeah. She goes, "Hi, just want to let you know that I'm here with Lauren, and she said that it was a big mistake to say yes to go to the prom with you."
Oh.
I said, "What? I'm the fucking DJ." So I ended up going with no prom date, and my prom pictures, for real, are with my grandmother.
So I went
from having the hottest girl in school to my 85-year-old grandmother, who I love. But it's actually a good memory. That girl moved to New York, and I actually saw her on the subway, but I didn't say anything. But maybe we should hit her up. That would have been so cool if I'm like, bring on Lauren.
Let's call her.
Oh, I see your nice tattoo. Yay!
It's supposed to go
on. On it. Let's do it. Riding.
Oh my God.
Ethan, for $500, we make it permanent.
No.
It'll cost $500 to make it.
Happy Father's Day.
That's what I'm thinking.
Happy Father's Day to everyone out there.
Come on, get a screenshot. Right now.
Get a screenshot.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's perfect. Oh,
love it, Jiggy.
Nailed it.
What is Rob's one? Yeah, Rob, you have another one.
There's only one thing that could best the tattoo on the forehead, and that's got to be the wig on top of the head with the tattoo.
Okay. Oh, who's that?
Don Yoon, thanks for the laughs. Thanks for your contribution. Stephanie Fagnini, thanks for showing us all the ways to cook in the kitchen with a parenthesis or quotes. Thank you. Lance Perry from Lance and Bonnie. From Lance and Bonnie, in reference to serial chat, shout out, Landon, wake up. Time to wake up, Landon, then hum the military bugle call. That was funny. That was a serial chat where I woke up a young boy. let's see, Heather McKinney. And yeah, I think that was it. So I think we're caught up on that. Let's see. What would I have to do next? Oh,
Rob,
okay. Well, let me get into character. Talk amongst yourselves.
Oh boy.
Hey Beth, we need another shotgun.
Oh Lord, okay. Hold on, I'm busy all typing. Hold on.
1 second.
Ask and you shall receive.
Yes, you shall receive. Hold on, let me get my
Vimeo. Shout out to Crystal White. Crystal White, shout out to you.
Well, guys, for $6,000 tonight, Jiggy's gonna turn his stove on and put his face to the fire.
Yeah, no.
Oh. We do have one more song left, though. We do have one more original song out there if anyone wants to do that.
I don't know. Cole and Steven look like they're plotting. I know you'll come up with something real good.
All right, y'all. Scent.
The suspense. She is a killer.
Atta girl.
Wait till you have the lights for Grandma.
My channel, do it. Come and jump on it.
Is it weird that I find this more attractive?
Like Napoleon Dynamite,
the ripping shirt.
Being here watching, everything will win it. Someone who knows how to ride. Grandma has never got down like this. Yo, my name is Grandma Jig. I got a friggin' tattoo of a fucking Playboy on my forehead. Grandma Jig coming in the house. Grandma Jig cooking up a mouse.
That's priceless.
Show your face. Thank you, Andrea.
Grandma Jig cooking up a scrimp. Grandma Jig in the house. All right, let's try this out. Grandma Jig coming in the house.
All right, this is recorded. Where does it go?
What?
This is recorded, so where does it go?
Pornhub.
Ethan keeps it in a vault.
Ethan, I'll pay you $1,000.
Big shout out to Alina as well. Thank you to Alina.
The only good thing about this is you cook like this normally, so it's less weird because you have an audience.
Yeah, by the way, this summer, because all the comedy clubs are closed, guys, serious. All the comedy clubs are pretty much closed. So if you guys want to book me to do something like this at your house, maybe a backyard show, maybe I'll bring Mike Charette with me. Hit up Ethan, or you can send me an email. Seriously, that all I'm going to do this summer is be dressing, stripping, and cooking. So if you want to I'm not doing any stand-up this summer, just cooking, and I'm bringing my wig and my tattoos. If you're into it, hit us up. Listen, I got my calendar wide open. Everything's been canceled, gang. I have my calendar wide open for this summer. If you'd like me to come to your hometown, tell some jokes, make some shrimp scampi, and bring my wig, then let's do it.
So do you come to Pennsylvania?
Yes, I will go to Pennsylvania.
What about the UK?
Guys, we've had Jiggy twice down here in Delaware, and he's absolutely awesome. There's
Dave, check out Jiggy right now.
Definitely want to. You definitely want to have him.
Invite me to Delaware. I'll come.
We can do that.
What about the UK?
He's got a Playboy tattoo.
I don't know if that's even physically possible at this point. But listen, if you have a boat and you can smuggle me into like
he's doing a show,
I'll do it.
UK still up? That's awesome.
We're allowing flights back into the country.
All right, gang. First, Grandma Jig's going to taste the fresh homemade pasta that you can make as well. Welcome home. First, we got to get, I hope it's well cooked. Ooh, that's got an excellent chew. I feel like Mary Berry. You guys want?
like Diggy a child.
Mary, love her. Ooh, that looks like a, it's a wonderful bake, but it's just a bit off.
Mary Berry doesn't slur.
This is Doubtfire.
You have better teeth.
Looking out for you, Jiggy.
Oh, is it good?
This is great. This is great. Lovely. Very nice.
Very nice.
Oh, we have a wheel spin from Beth. God knows what she wants Grandma Jig to do.
We already know.
Any guesses? Right.
Bring it back on. What do I already? Oh, I just do it.
You know what it is.
Come on, Jiggy.
What is it?
She wants me to shotgun a beer. What do you think it
is? Yes. Not just any beer.
R&H beer.
Yes.
Okay. Beth, here we go. I
can't have our R&H beer here yet. Yeah.
None of us can.
Is it just me?
All right, Ethan.
And it's the last one, I promise. No more.
Well, he doesn't have it. It's his last one anyway.
Yeah. Okay, here we go, gang. Bring this over. Can you guys see me?
Don't forget,
Ethan. I think he kind of looks like Doc Brown.
British. All right, here we go.
Ooh, rough. That was a little rough.
Making the hole, mate. All right. I did it the wrong way again. I'm a righty. God damn it. All right, Mike.
One.
This is my life now, Mike Charette.
Cheers.
This is it. Me and Mike have done, I would say sold out casinos, but usually about 3 to 8 people come. But casino gigs is now down to this.
Cheers.
All right. Beth, cheers. You got a drink?
Cheers, Jiggy.
Thank you.
Hmm.
Woo! Someone knows how to ride. Guys, should I auction this shirt off?
Yeah.
I'll send this to your hometown. Jiggy authentic stripper shirt.
It's on the website.
Put it on the website. All right, let me see where we're at as far as the tip jar here. I have a song going to Victoria Seville. You're gonna get a song. Met you in London last year. You were awesome. Please sing Bye Bye Bye. Oh my God, with pleasure. I'll sing that to you. That's gonna be coming to you tomorrow. Tracy Murphy, shout out to Rob and Steve and Nicole for creating Grandma Jig. Thank you. I'm never taking this off, by the way. This is my new persona. I'm changing my Twitter handles to Grandma Jig. I think, honestly, this is more viral than anything I'll ever do in my life. I'll never create anything this memorable. Who could create a character who cooks, has a Playboy sticker on their forehead, and is a, has a wig and a beard?
It's already been posted, Jiggy.
What?
It's already been posted.
I was worried about that.
plenty of shots.
Let's see where we're at. If we're close to the goal here, how far off we are. Let's see. We're pretty close. We're actually a little bit short. So I want to wrap this up in 10 minutes because I want to try the waxing thing. We're 300 short, but we're 300 short. Let's see. We'll see what we can do. Let's do a story wheel and see if anyone wants to kick in. If you want to kick in to the show, it's at Jiggy Comedy on Venmo or PayPal. We're a little bit short, and if we do, I'm going to wax my damn leg. So,
Jiggy, no, you're not. No, you're not.
Yeah, I have wax stuff.
No, you're not, bro.
I wax my leg.
You're not, dude.
Where is he waxing?
I'm going to wax my leg. I'm just up. First time I ever got drunk. Well, kids, back when I was a kid in the 1920s, it was Prohibition times. It was back in the Prohibition times. And I don't know if anyone remembers, but a long time ago, back in the 20s, there was a drink called Four Loko.
nasty.
Remember that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so before I moved to Florida, I was a sophomore in high school, and I drank my first Four Loko, and then I also drank half of a bottle of coconut rum. Oh. And I ended up at my dentist, my mom's a dental hygienist, her boss, who is a dentist, I ended up at his house drinking coconut rum, and I passed out under his pool table the day before I moved to Florida. His older son threw a party at their house and the dentist was away. So I got smashed to the point where I can never even smell coconut rum to this day. I can't even get near it. And I passed out underneath his pool table, and he was older than me. He was in college. He snuck me out of the house at 6 in the morning and dropped me off on my doorstep. Someone who knows how to ride. Let's see what we got here. We have a shout out coming in, and let's see, and we have a shout out for Carla Roberts. Thank you for your contribution. And let's see, Bonnie Goodhart just threw another big contribution, and Bonnie gets a wheel spin. We're getting pretty close to that goal. Bonnie, what would you like to see?
Story, please.
What?
Story.
Story. All right. Spin that story wheel for Bonnie.
That's easy, Bonnie.
That's too easy.
Oh, we also got a shot for Gwendolyn Gibson, which I'll do before the story. Shot for Gwendolyn. Housekeeping in hotels. Oh, my God. Okay.
That was quick.
This shot is going to go to Gwendolyn Gibson. There's a shot. Thank you.
Cheers, Gwendolyn.
Cheers, Gwendolyn. Thank you so much. Grandma, thanks you.
Just call me Gwen.
Gwen, that was quite a treat. Thank you, Gwen. Okay, housekeeping in hotels always bothers me because they will service your room at 7 a.m. unless you put a do not disturb sign on your door. They don't give a fuck about you. The thing about housekeeping is that if you don't, everyone when they go to a hotel, put a do not disturb on your door, because if you don't, they will start knocking at 7 a.m. I think I told the story once before. This is true. On the Impractical Jokers cruise, on the last day of the cruise, I forgot to put my do not disturb sign on the door on the last morning of the cruise, and housekeeping came into my room at 7 a.m. and I'm in my bed shirt. I'm drunk from the night before. And they look at me and they're like, oh, sorry, we thought you left. I'm like, we're still at sleep. Where did you think I was going to go? I'm looking at the ocean in front of me. What did you think I was going to jump overboard on a boat? It's 7 o'clock in the morning. Get out of my room. They're trying to check rooms. Like, where am I going to go? Jump off into an island? Moral of the story is always put a do not disturb on your door.
Always.
Always.
If there's ever a clue again.
Why would you leave yourself open to get bothered? Who goes to sleep without the do not disturb is a better question.
Or robbed, bro.
What?
Housekeepers, man. They'll take stuff. They'll take stuff out of your hotel room while you're not there if you don't put that do not disturb thing on there. That's a little hack.
You never really know, really.
Not all the time. But
Mike, do you have any embarrassing tales?
No, I have none. My life has been perfect. It's just been nothing but success.
Shout out to Diana Marker. Thank you for your contribution, Diana. Appreciate it. Let's see how close we are here to the goal. We're $115 off. $115. We can amount to it. I've got 175 people on here. All we need is like a few people to do it.
Or we can do it next time.
Or we can do it next time. Grandma don't care.
No, we're not doing it next time. Screw that.
Beth, where are you?
I'm right here. Hold on.
Crowdsourcing for We Are Legion.
Yeah, but I'm only, I can't do it. I can't do another 100, y'all.
I didn't do it. I didn't say 100.
Somebody help us, please.
I'm working with someone too. I think we have a donation coming in, so we'll see.
Wait, Nicole, wait, and I see you. Let's go.
It's coming.
You want to hit up Justin to get ready on the after show. How does this work? Oh my God, this is going to
I think you have to heat it up.
No, you just got to like put it on your leg and then you like rub it on your leg.
Nicole did it. Okay, Nicole did it. Julia, thank you.
Nicole, you're a legend.
Nicole is a legend. She's getting
one more face tattoo.
And Beth.
One more face tattoo.
Well, we got a shot for Beth. We'll do a shot for Beth.
No more shotgun, just a shot.
Shot,
Beth.
One more.
So Grandma Jig, how was Becky, you after thank you, Becky. Time?
Thank you, Becky.
Did you get rum?
Are we, so are what? We there?
Yeah,
we're there.
Yeah. Yes.
Huzzah.
Yep.
Huzzah.
Oh, Coffee Rescue just said, put us over the top. Shout out to the Coffee Rescue. Thank you so much, Coffee Rescue. I know you're in there.
Jamie.
It's Jamie from Jamie. Coffee Rescue. I know.
Shout out.
Big shout out to Jamie from Coffee Rescue. You guys, for putting us over the top here. You guys all did it. Thank you. I know we have a few more shout outs. Let me do that before we hit into the waxing. Becky Casaquillo, thank you. And is that it? We're cut out. Does Jamie from Coffee Rescue want to come on?
Where is she?
Is she on?
Forgetting her.
Oh, there she is. Shout out to Colleen Beaton as well. Benton. So do you have anything from the wheel you want to see before I do this?
I did it. Wait, what are all the things that you have like down there on the couch? Besides the wig, you had other things.
This one I'm actually surprised. No one did the world's hottest chocolate. What?
That's next time.
I'm just glad we got there. I just want to see the leg shaving.
It's not shaving.
Waxing.
I was like, I got to do this. Let's do it.
All right. Well, if you want
to, I've got my giant bottle of alcohol too. Let's do this.
Oh.
Colleen. Yeah. Yeah, Colleen.
I know, right?
So do you want
to do it? What do you got on the table? What do you got on the table?
I can do my hair filler. I have fake nails. I have the world's hottest chocolate, which literally has a warning sticker of like, don't do this.
Is that ball sauce? Is it ball sauce?
Yeah, that's the ball sauce.
Is that ball sauce?
Ball sauce! You need the ball sauce!
The world's hottest chocolate bar.
Oh.
Next time we need the ball sauce.
I just checked on
I didn't Amazon that. I got
I didn't say that.
So Jamie, what do you want to see?
I don't know. I've had a lot of these. So let's just do something.
All right, let's do the waxing?
That's what I want to see.
All right, well, let's do it.
That's my ultimate goal.
Yeah, but
so let's give the chair.
The leg is the easy part.
The what?
You know it.
Underarm.
No.
You want to do an underarm?
Gotta do
underarm. I thought he was
it
just
really
doing the leg.
Underarm hurts a lot.
Mm-hmm. No, leg hurts so much worse.
But I don't get to choose, right? It's just like leg, and that's it.
No.
Bobby, you look so horrified.
Oh my god. This is not good.
I'm having a hard time finding raspberry chocolate ball sauce on Amazon.
Not good.
Who is looking at you, a legend?
I don't think any grandma's ever done this.
Jiggy, oh my god. The more weird shit you send Jiggy, the more fun we have on these shows. So please send him more weird stuff.
Well, as soon as I find that chocolate ball sauce, and I'll.
That
I'll
is not a good spot. I mean, that's going to hurt.
Get a kitchen towel, Jiggs.
No, get a rawhide stick to bite on it.
Yes.
Get a rocket.
It's so willingly helping
you. That's so fleshy. Kitchen towel, bite on it.
Something like,
oh my god,
can I find Kelly Clarkson?
Kitchen towel, bite on it. Do
let her
thing.
Rip it off. Let her rip it off.
You want to rip it off?
Yeah, get him back.
It is payback. She deserves this. Your girlfriend deserves it.
Yourself.
There you go, Jiggs.
One, two, three.
Oh, no.
You're inducing labor.
He did that next time. He had to do it on his stomach.
Oh my god. Well,
Jiggy, it could be in a workplace. It could be your bikini line.
I'm icing you with a White Castle burger. all right. Well, thank you for coming. I really had a lot of fun. If you guys want to send more contributions, I'll leave the tip jar open through the night. It's at Jiggy Comedy on Venmo or PayPal. I also have I have Tastes Funny like this as a concept. Also remember, I'm only doing private events through the summer because there's nowhere I can perform. So if you're interested in doing something, send me a DM on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram, or send Ethan a message and we'll plan something. I have a lot of leg left to wax. and then also I have the merch page as well. If you want to throw up the link, Ethan, if you have another, or Brandon, if you're on here, if you want to throw the link up there to, if you guys want to grab Tastes Funny merch from a show like this. This is really a lot of fun. It's all for fun. You know what I mean? So I do this purposely. I pick this stuff out because I know I can handle it. But my whole goal is to make sure you guys have fun and to have a little bit of a break what's going on in the real world, which I think we all need sometimes. Thank you guys so much for coming. We have DJ Justin Gerais, who's awesome. He's gonna be doing the dance party. I'm gonna be hanging out, cleaning up the kitchen, and dancing with you. And we're gonna be hanging out for a little bit longer. But thank you guys so much. This was a lot of fun. Justin Gerais, is he on? Is he ready to roll?
There he is.
There we go. All right, Justin Gerais, take it over. It's all you, bud.
Got 5 seconds to get to the dance floor.